Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting. Today's video is coming by my confusion. Lately I see many artists, many Jung journal creators to use masterboard, and I was a little bit confused by that. What that mean? Why it's now the paper, which from the first point of view looks like collage paper, it's called now masterboard. So I did my small research on Google, and today I'm coming to share with you how I do understand. It doesn't have to be for everybody same, but how I do understand those differences between a Franken paper, collage paper, and masterboard. For all of them, you can use your scraps. Everything you saved in the past from your previous projects, you can use now. And I'm gonna start with Franken paper, and then we will continue. So for Franken paper, we're gonna use scraps, and for Franken paper, it's good if you know both sides of your paper, what is the difference, and if you actually like both sides of your paper, because Franken paper, it's visible from both sides. I mean, the background of your paper will be visible because you are gluing the papers together just with edges, and you are putting them to larger sheet. So if you don't like, really don't like one side of your paper, you should save it for collage paper. That is the difference, that Franken paper, it's like stitched from many pieces to one large one, and you can actually see both these sides. So you will glue your pages or your scraps together in one large project, and you can add those papers by looking on both sides and kind of putting it together. Oh, look at me. Good. Putting it together by looking on both sides to make sure you actually like what you create. So if this will be here, from other side, I will see this one, and I'm okay with that. So I'm gonna glue it here. And this one is the same from both sides. Yep. I don't need that big. And once you have some larger piece done, you can take a ruler and just cut with a ruler your paper to the straight position. And you do have done your Franken paper, where you can see both sides of your scraps. So for Franken paper, I would say be more careful of the choice of your papers. If you don't like one side of your paper, save it for collage paper, which is coming now. For collage paper, you should use some base. It can be cardstock, it can be normal paper, or it can be even old wrapping or packing paper, as I am using here. And on that paper you are putting your scraps, and again you are creating kind of like your pattern. And you can use any kind of scraps you like. And for this paper, it's best to use scraps from the paper where you maybe don't like one side. Let's say here, if I will choose, I don't like this one, and I will definitely use this. So I will save these for my collage paper, and I will glue them on my base sheet the way I would like to see that paper. So if I don't like this size, I will definitely use that top one. And again, like before, you are creating from your scraps some kind of pattern. Like here, this is kind of too dark. I like it, but it's too dark, so I will rather use this a little bit softer side. And that way, with your scraps, you're gonna create your amazing collage paper. And really, it depends how you would like to use your scraps. If you want to have more ripped or more dimensional, so as many layers you will add. Maybe you want to add also offcuts from die cutting. Use it for that, and that way you will create your collage paper, which is from the pieces on one side and one solid pattern on other side. That's from my understanding is collage paper. And now masterboard. So that was what was confusing me. And I went to Google and I found that masterboard has few different explanations, but all of them are kind of in mixed media style. From the dictionary, the masterboard is a calcium silicate board reinforced with selected fibers and fillers. And it's sanded on the one side and smooth on that reverse side. From art, the masterboard is a self-made mixed media patterned paper that the artist creates herself. And by that, I do understand that masterboard, it's something where you can use paper, fabric, modeling paste, and you are creating your own basic paper, which you will use later in your project. And that's what we will create now. I'm gonna start again with my scraps, but this time I'm gonna pull out also scraps from my fabrics, and I will add them here and there in my board. So I do have here my scraps, I do have a bunch of fabric, and there are also like pieces like this, and I think, yeah, pieces of lace and cheesecloth. So that's what I've got here. And I'm gonna start again with the paper. I'm gonna put my scraps on that base paper in some kind of pattern, and then we will build the rest around. So I did glue my paper, which is now collage paper, and from that I'm gonna go a little bit more. And that's my understanding what actually masterboard is, that you will add there also different things than it's just paper. You will add there paintings, you will add there modeling paste, you will add there pieces of fabric. Maybe you will even sew through to that paper and do a little bit more than it's just collage paper, which is mostly just from paper. So this is my understanding, and I'm gonna use few different things which I think they should be on masterboard. So first I'm using my very weird pieces of fabric. Oh my, what is that? Okay. Yeah, and because there can be used also modeling paste and stamps and paintings. We're gonna go for it. And I'm gonna use it here as well. If you would like to know how to start on your empty page, I would highly recommend Marta from Maremi Small Art. She did in the past few amazing tutorials, and I think it's called How to Break Blank Page. I know it's for mixed media, for those beautiful, beautiful mixed media projects, but it's a really perfect tutorial how to start. How do not be afraid to put something on the paper. If you are not sure what you actually want to create, her tutorials with this How to Break Blank Page, I do believe it's called this way, they are just amazing, really. You will learn so much. And she always finished, I think she mostly finished one or two those those basic boards she created. So go to have a look. I will try to find the link, at least for one of these tutorials. From that, you can go and find those others. But I think she does have at least three videos on this theme, maybe even more. But they are really amazing, amazing. So I'm editing my fabrics to that board. And I think I'm gonna place one more here. And then I'm gonna have a look what kind of paste or painting I wanna use. And I'm gonna do also a little bit of painting. So here, this one. So I decided to go with white acrylic paint. And first I'm gonna use my brayer. And go with brayer just here and there and add there some painting. But I don't want to cover it too much with that painting. I still want to see my papers underneath. So I go like really very lightweight, not too much, to make sure I will still see the patterns, but there will be some kind of painting. Sorry for that noise. Good is that on those fabrics you can also clean your brayer. And then what I will do, I think I will try to do, if that is possible, yeah, some heavy splashes. Oops, yeah, even these, why not? And I'm gonna take my heating tool and just dry it. And as you can see, I do have really heavy splashes, so I'm gonna leave it there. I'm gonna take my heating tool and dry my board. So I think my master board, it's dry, that painting, and I wanna do there a little bit more. So I'm gonna take my glue. It doesn't matter what kind of glue you're gonna use, it will work with any kind of glue, I guess. And I've got here cinnamon, the spice you are using in the kitchen. And I'm gonna do a little bit rusty effect. So I'm editing glue and I'm spreading the cinnamon on it. Tap, 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 tap. and with brush. Yeah, this way it will be best. So with my finger I am editing a glue on the spots I want. Kind of spread it the way I want. And with the brush, I'm editing the cinnamon. One more time, cinnamon, the spice we are using in the kitchen. And I am creating kind of like rusty effect on my paper. So I do have my master board done, but it's not done totally. Those last touches will be when I will create actually something from that master board. So I will add those last touches. And that is, what is it about? That you are creating some kind of papers. Franken paper I will totally use as a journal pages, because it's just calling for that to be used in journal, as journaling pages. They are amazing to look. They are so interesting to look at that. So Franken paper, where you can see both sides of your papers, I will use as a journal pages. The collage paper I will probably use for pockets, tags, and some decorations, some small decorations in my journals. So I would create basics like this, the string envelope, because I just love these envelopes and it's very easy to create it with those collage papers. Base for my postcard, base for a tag, and also some mini folder, because they are just so cute to add them to your journals. And what I will create from master board, that will be probably, not probably, that will be definitely frames, because it has so much texture, and base for ATC cards like this. So these are my ATCs ready to be decorated and used for artist trading cards. And these are my very unique frames and I really love them. Every single one is unique, every single one looks different, and they do have already texture because of those laces and fabric I used. And I think that it's a very decorative way to use your scraps. And I actually like, if I do understand right what the master board means, I actually like to create my frames for my journals this way. So I guess, if I didn't understand right, please feel free to correct me in the comments down below. I will love to hear from you how you do understand those differences between Franken paper, like this, between collage paper, which we can use for tags, folders, maybe postcards, once I will decorate it, of course, or pockets, and that master board, which I think it's the best to use for frames, because it does have that beautiful texture, and for ATC cards. So this was my sharing for today, my understanding of these differences. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you like it. Thank you so much for visiting me today. Thank you so much for jumping in and spending your time with me today. Have a beautiful day. Take care about yourself, and I will see you soon. Bye.